Is everybody that they get back where we came from?
And oh, it is true, 'tis true. Thank you, James.
And when he was living in Christchurch, he used to write copious, very amusing letters to the editor of the Christchurch Star. Now, seagulls, the pest problem. Sir, the seagull population in town is proliferating at an alarming rate. School holidays are coming up, and it should be possible to recruit a few of the better sort of boy to off a few. The lads would be glad of the sport and a little extra pocket money at this time of year, and in general, the citizens would welcome the demise of a raucous and unpleasant pest. Signed, William Douglas, which was one of the many pen names of James Finlayson-Bald. One of the replies, Sir, William Douglas is apparently unaware that both the red-billed and black-billed gulls are fully protected by law. If it is desirable to reduce their population in town, then people should stop feeding them. James E. Orchard. Number three. Sir, may I be permitted to join the outcry against the decimation of the seagull population? Any Navy man worth his salt will inform William Douglas that these birds are the souls of our dear departed chief stokers, doubly protected, legally and morally. Bless them. H.S. Latimer. Number four. Sir, William Douglas.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Sir, William Douglas would expect some flack, surely, on his letter advocating the destruction of seagulls. It's beyond any comprehension that we have citizens of this kind of thinking, encouraging schoolboys to break the law with the illegal use of firearms is not on. And who would pay them? Certainly not the new council, I would hope. We want conservative conservation, not welcome demise. L.J. Perkaskey. Now, in reply to this, Sir, in reply to J. Perkaskey, I certainly did not advocate putting weapons into the hands of just any boy. We are fortunate that Christchurch is home to several public schools, one or more of which is sure to have a cadet corps. This is the kind of lad we require. Right attitudes and facing up to responsibility. As for the council contribution, I recall that the main plank of our new Lady Mayor's bid for office was a promise of vastly increased employment opportunities. Signed, William Douglas. Thank you, John, and his journey. And I mean, I think it's done probably, but I think it's at least interesting. What Aramis packed up for James to accompany him. So Aramis?
So he's off to Calvary, because the naughty gods like to pray for Satan, make funny jokes like that. So as well as his hat, he'd have to be provisioned for that long day's journey into the night and the light, that Via Della Rosa through the Bardos. Fortunately, I had a picnic hamper. Here's one I prepared earlier. Okay, so my daughter Angelique, decoupage, a 12-inch cube with some of that Yuko origami paper, a Yuko's one from the floating world. Forgive my Japanese, poor Japanese. And the food, I had some improvised sashimi bonito box, unbroken chopsticks. And anyone who dined with James would know how fastidious he was that the chopsticks must be unbroken. It was not that. To use chopsticks. We had a little wasabi, we had the soy sauce dish, a packet of instant miso soup, and the ersatz sashimi was a single serve can of tuna. For the drinks, we had the green, black, and matcha tea powder, as well as some nice Balinese coffee from my village in Bali. We had some of that Vidillo. I don't know how you say it, but I might say it. I'd like to say Vidillo because it rhymes with Bordillo. Wine that my son's friend, from my son's friend's boutique vineyard. And some of you are maybe might have a drink of that sometime. The dessert, we had the handmade chocolates filled with Italian liqueurs, some Italian and Japanese biscuits, some Italian gummy candy full of artificial goodness but delicious, a sake cup, a little bottle of H2O. And after all that, since you might have needed to rest on this arduous journey off into the unknown of years, I threw in a kimono. Some white bamboo socks. And a lavender eye pillow.
Over whatever the combination of what he ever had and the treatment, he was hallucinating. And, in that kind of hospital, he was on the way over to the hospital. And after it settled down, he said to me, a nurse came by, and in the nurses, said, oh, and I just suppose it was just like a bad trip, wasn't it? And he said, I've never had a bad trip. And he had hundreds, he's dropped acid hundreds of times. And he was just full of things like that.
We're all lovely down here, and we know that you're with us. Down memory lane, in loving memory of our James Finlayson-Bald. Down memory lane, with James, our wonderful friend, El Alamein weeps. And this is a chorus. Down, 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 down memory lane, we'll stroll forevermore. Weeps for the battles, whether and that poppies bloom, drenched by those who mourn. Down, 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 memory lane, we'll stroll forevermore. James, we mourn for you, but now you are your spirit. But know your spirit's alive, drenched. Oh, sorry. Know your spirit's alive in heaven's concert halls. Down, 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 memory lane. We'll stroll forevermore. Thank you.
What do you do?
I ran the bookshop.
How long did you do that?
5 years.
Okay. Did you find any interesting books?